1990 here on ESPN Classic. We now move ahead in the first half.
Welcome to the Pete Maravich Assembly Center in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. I'm James Brown along with Quinn Buckner, where today is the LSU Tigers hosting the Loyola Marymount Lions. Our score, LSU is leading 11-8, 15:34 remaining in the first half. And Quinn, surprisingly, LSU says they were going to approach this game and have some fun today. And the person who's making it most fun thus far is Shaquille O'Neal.
Well, there was one way to get him involved, and what LSU has done is got him involved on the defensive end. He's blocked three shots here in the first 4.5 minutes of the game. And what it's allowed LSU to do is to get into their transition game. Obviously, the missed opportunities keeps LMU out of theirs. But I guarantee you, where LMU beats you is not so much on the missed or blocks. It's on makes. If you make it, they get the ball back on the other end faster than anybody in college basketball.
Again, still in the early going, but are you a little surprised, particularly when Dale Brown of LSU made some adjustments prior to the game by going to a much smaller lineup than he's accustomed to?
Yeah, he made a good change. He got Duvall in the game, and that was a wise choice. Randy Duvall is a better ball handler than anybody else they had on the court. So with Jackson Williamson and Duvall, you have three ball handlers on the court. You can work against the press of LMU.
So take a look at Dale Brown. This is what you've missed in the early going. Chris Jackson, 3 points. Kimble and Gathers combined for 8. But the story has been Shaquille O'Neal, 4 blocks already. He's 3 away from tying the LSU record, and he's been an absolute monster on the boards.
Well, we didn't have up there, though, James. He had 2 dunks on the offensive rebound, so he's been extremely active on both ends.
This is Hank Gathers, rebounded by Shaquille O'Neal, nicknamed Shaq. That's his 6th rebound in the contest. 4 minutes into the first half. This is Stanley Roberts. And the 7-foot sophomore drops in the jumper. And it's a 13-8 LSU lead. And Chris Jackson is going to be whistled for his first personal foul. Loyola Marymount comes into the game leading the nation in scoring 121 points an outing, giving new meaning to the term up-tempo.
Well, they really are up-tempo. Their last game, James, they had 150 points.
Jeff Fryer yet to score. He's a third leading scorer on the Lions squad. This is Randy Duvall. Got the start in place of Harold Boudreaux. Chris Jackson, sweet move. And a 7-point LSU lead.
This is where they get you, coming back on the other end. They missed the shot, but they really push it up hard, does LMU.
And O'Neal has been swallowing up every rebound. Jackson, again. 7 points on the afternoon for Chris Jackson. And Fryer, who says he has absolutely no conscience from three-point land, shows why.
He's the hired gun. They told him when you get it and you're in position, shoot it. And Fryer can shoot with the best of them.
Only 1 of 7 thus far, Fryer is.
JB, he went 0 for 11 from three-point line once and kept taking it. The 12th one he made, because Westhead just tells him, when you open, shoot the ball.
So Stanley Roberts, size advantage indeed, and drops it in over Per Steamer from Sweden. Steamer only 6'7". Lowry.
That's the trade we talked about. That's the 3-for-2 trade. I will give LSU the basket on their end of the court, but you come back on the other end and you see LMU will take a 3-pointer for the 2-point opportunity almost every time down.
Chris Jackson said before the game he would love this type of pace because he can really show his individual moves.
Well, he's been compared to Isaiah Thomas, and I would suggest to you players like Chris Jackson and Isaiah play well in open court contests. You saw a bit of the ability of Chris Jackson to the hole that time.
Terrell Lowry picking up his first personal foul.
His first personal foul.
And that's the second, make that third team foul. To take a look at Paul Westhead in his 5th year at Loyola Marymount. He says it takes a wacky coach to install this kind of system, but it's paying big dividends.
Well, James, he's run this offense every place he's been. He seems to have better athletes now with Gathers, Kimbles, and Fryer. So it looks as though it's wacky to everybody else. It's what Paul Westhead has always done.
Mild-mannered professor working over the officials. This is Maurice Williamson. Good pass into Wayne Sims, and he's fouled. Wayne Sims, the elder statesman on this LSU squad. A junior. There are no seniors on the Tiger squad.
Well, you know, I'm talking to Wayne. I think one of the things that are really going to be important for LSU is this young man here. Wayne Sims, being the elder statesman, has to get the younger players. Shaquille O'Neal, Stanley Roberts, Harold Boudreaux, who has not been in the game, as well as Chris Jackson, to understand, guys, there are times when we run, there are times when we set up. this young man understands the system better than any of those other players, so it's really important that he impart his wisdom on the newcomer.
As he nails his second free throw, the foul was assessed to Terrell Lowry, his second personal foul, 14th foul. And Lowry comes right back, slammed by Bo Kimble, the nation's leading scorer, showing his jumping ability.
Well, Bo likes playing in there. He played center in high school, so he can get up.
Kimble stands 6'5", but jumps like he's 6'10".
Boy, when you like to see people get out, but the thing that sets this up is Tony Walker right now has Shaquille O'Neal guessing what's going to happen. Nobody blocks out Bo Kimble, and you see him get up, kind of hold on to the rim a little bit to protect himself.
You never know, he had knee surgery last year as Pear Steamer misses. Kimble on the rebound, fouled by Randy Duvall. So a 21-16 lead in early going here in the first half, 13-29 remaining, LSU on top. First personal foul on Randy Duvall. Take a look. Jeff Fryer into the contest for LMU, replaced by Tom Peabody, number 11.
Peabody comes in. They call Peabody the human bruise, always on the floor after the loose ball. And Vernell Singleton will come in on the other side. He's for the same purpose as Tom Peabody for LMU. Singleton on the floor. He and Williamson keeps the tempo up defensively. But this is a guy you have to keep your eye on because Bo Kimble has shot a lot of shots during the season, during the summer. He can really score with the basketball.
5 points and four rebounds on the afternoon for Bo Kimble. Chris Jackson, full court press by the Lions. Up to, this is Vernell Singleton. Lions right back. Kimble from 9-point land as he nails that one and cuts the deficit to three. 23-20 Tigers. Maurice Williamson, air ball. There is no need for a 45-second clock for either of these teams today.
Well, I agree with you, and LMU has it at 5.4. I will guarantee you in about 3 minutes, you'll see all of a sudden that the time possession for LSU also will go down because they get caught up in the tempo of Loyola.
Well, getting caught up in the action right now, Shaquille O'Neal, 6 points. Kimble hammered from behind by Vernell Singleton. But they're actually going to call the foul on Shaquille O'Neal. Actually, the official had his pick that time, either Singleton or O'Neal. O'Neal only 17 years old, playing like a veteran pro.
Well, I'll tell you what he's really got is he's got a big heart. You know, you talk to him about getting things done. I said, are you worried about tomorrow's game? I asked him yesterday. He said, Quinn, I think I got the heart to play with anybody in the country. I'll be there to play. And you can see that he's come here to play this afternoon.
Bo Kimble picks up his 9th point. Communications major, as a matter of fact, there's a pregame show for the radio station that carries the Lions games.
He wants our job.
he already
told me that, Quinn, I want your job.
25-22 LSU lead, 12:50 remaining in the first half. This is Chris Jackson, Maurice Williamson, Harold Boudreaux, Vernell Singleton with the ball, and Shaquille O'Neal, the flyer for LSU. This is Bo Kimble for the Lions. Peabody to Gathers, and he's fouled. The foul will be assessed on Harold Boudreaux.
JB, that's what you get all afternoon. They just come at you. And that time, if you get the guards, as LSU did, down on the baseline on their offensive end, there's no way they can get back defensively. And Chris Jackson, I thought, took a bad defensive gamble, allowing the numbers to, again, accrue to the advantage of Loyola.
Back in the game for Loyola Marymount, Jeff Fryer, number 21, and John O'Connell, a 6'6 sophomore.
The story here for this young man, he shoots free throws left-handed. I marvel at.
Marvel because he is a right-handed shooter. Quinn, why did he go to the left-handed free throw shooting style?
Well, when you talk to him about it, he said he struggled so much shooting with his right hand and he had more confidence in the left. He's got a better rotation because he can get his left hand into a better cock position to shoot the basketball.
One of two at the free throw line. He's only a 56% free throw shooter. And we have a turnover, 5 seconds. Now, again, keep in mind this year, the 5 second rule just release the ball before 5 seconds. Doesn't have to touch anyone. This is Gathers. Tries to jump hook over O'Neal. Not intimidated by him, but O'Neal is making him pay. Off the hands of Singleton, back to the Lions.
number 34, Randy DeVall. Replacing number 24, Burnell Singleton.
Randy DeVall back in for Burnell Singleton, and Stanley Roberts comes in for Shaquille O'Neal. And Dale Brown said that he would be substituting liberally for obvious reasons. He may give players a stint as long as 5 or 6 minutes max.
Good idea, particularly with his big players, Roberts and Shaquille O'Neal. But DeVall is back into the game because of the 5 second turnover. They've got to get the ball inbound.
And you see the shot clock to the left of your screen will give you some idea as to how quickly these two teams will put it up. And that's the longest that the Lions have held the ball in that possession. This is Fryer from three-point land. Air ball. Rebounded. LSU, Maurice Williamson. And there he is, Tom Peabody.
Coming to take a little
visit. The man they call the human bruise, as you mentioned. They warned us about him to keep all liquids off the table because we would be doused. We were forewarned and prepared.
In our family, men lose their hair early.
Thank you.
By the time we hit 30, we don't have to invest much in combs. So I started using Rogaine when I was like 28 at the first sign of fallout. Before I looked like I needed it, because I know I would. So here I am. I've been using Rogaine for about 2 years now, right at the source of the problem, and I don't see any difference. And that's the idea, you keep the hair you have. Look, I love my dad. I'm just not in a rush to look like him.
Simple, safe, smart. Rogaine, it's stronger than heredity.
First, we reinvented the Roadster with the Mazda Miata. Now, we've reinvented financing with Mazda's innovative new progressive payment plan. If you qualify, Mazda's progressive payment plan will dramatically lower your payments for the first year. Mazda, re-engineering the way you buy a car. See your Mazda dealer or log on to MazdaUSA.com today for details.
The Rick, this is Sean with ESPN Fantasy Baseball. We only use stats from players in the AL and the NL. We do not accept stats from the RL, the Rick League. Stop faxing us your wiffle ball stats. You're jamming up our machine.
This is ESPN Classic.
Sick.
A packed house here at the Maravich Assembly Center on the campus of Louisiana State University. And an enthusiastic crowd indeed. Their Tigers out in front, 25-23.
Well, we got a great game. There's all kind of reasons to be excited. I'm excited because I wanted to see LMU's offense, and LSU is proving up to the task.
Nice pass from Randy DeVall to Stanley Roberts, his sixth point.
Stanley Roberts is a player that's starting to learn this game. He's got to learn at the inside that he's got to be aggressive, as he was that time.
Shaquille O'Neal with yet another block and a rebound. Bo Kimble, Maurice Williamson shot. Here comes Lowry to gather. And the foul against Shaquille O'Neal, his second personal foul. And Ken, I'm calling you Q and Quinn. The thing I like about Gathers is at least he's not being intimidated by O'Neal. He's taking it right to him.
He took the ball to the basket, which I think is exactly what you have to do against O'Neal. You make him exposing the fouls. But the play was made by Tony Walker. He got up, made O'Keefe commit himself, and once he did, he gave it to Gathers, and then O'Keefe tried to come back. Gathers took it to the basket.
Gathers is aware that there are a number of NBA scouts here today, including Jerry Krause, an executive with the Chicago Bulls. He said one of his principal objectives is to prove that he can play inside against the big guys, which he would have to do, of course, at the next level.
Well, he's going to have to use his quickness on the next level to play, because all of those guys obviously are going to be a great deal taller than players in college.
LSU turnover. The Lions force teams into 24 turnovers a game. Lowry off the mark. This is Maurice Williamson. As most people know now, the son of John Williamson, former NBA great. Chris Jackson off the mark. This is Randy DeVall. Didn't play high school ball at all.
Well, he was a little bit like Keith Smart from Indiana University. He went to the same junior college, but neither of them played very much basketball in high school and have proven to be very good college players.
Blocked by Shaquille O'Neal, but it looks like he's going to pick up his third personal foul. Now, in SEC conference play, of course, they play with the sixth personal foul rule. Today, they're playing with regular rules. He'll only get five, so he's going to come out of the game.
I think that rule hurts you if you play all year playing the six-foul rule and you go into NCAA competition trying to be the champion of college, I think you get into a bad habit playing that way. Right now, they have to make a decision whether or not to get O'Neal out. They should get him out.
Okay,
I agree.
Guys.
You see, the thing you do, again, take the ball to the basket with aggressiveness, and there's no question that there's a lot of body by Shaquille O'Neal. In 2 years, he'll block that without there being any foul call.
Lowry converts both free throws, a sophomore from Oakland, California. So Vernell Singleton at 6'7", the sophomore, replaces Shaquille O'Neal, who leads with 6 points, 9 rebounds, and 6 blocked shots, which ties him for the school record, that is, in blocked shots. He's got a total of 61. This is Gathers. And a blocking foul called on Vernell Singleton.
I know the officials and Dale Brown don't agree with that. I thought that was the call to make, because Hank Gathers did an outstanding job of getting away from the defense.
Fans didn't like it, but take a look.
Watch him. All of a sudden, he looks like he's going up straight. He'll take a step away from the basket.
That's a good call.
Yeah, it's a good call. It's tough to see from that angle, but from my angle, it was right on it, and it was tough for the defender to get there in position.
First personal foul on Vernell Singleton. Now, although a defensive player can still be moving and legitimately take a charge, that time Singleton didn't have himself square nor position properly before Gathers took off. Loyola Marymount, 11 of 13 from the free throw line. LSU has been to the charity stripe only 3 times. They're 3 of 3. 1 of 2 for Hank Gathers with the left-handed free throw. 10:41 remaining in the first half. 1-point ball game. Singleton hammered hard by Bo Kimble.
No real malintent on that foul by Bo Kimble. You could see him mouth the words, "Are you all right?" Again, you don't let people take, you don't want to let somebody take a shot uncontested in there. Bo Kimble just got in there. Just a good hard foul.
First personal on Bo Kimble. 15 foul on the Lions. Vernell Singleton had a strong freshman year, of course, just overshadowed by the sensational Chris Jackson.
Just
Singleton
slightly.
From Natchez, Mississippi, one solid all-around player.
Well, he is an all-around player. They had him playing some center for a while, so he's had to make the adjustment back to the forward spot, and he's played guard as well. So it's been a matter of adjustment for Vernell, and I don't think he's been able to get it all done right away.
This is Fryer from three-point land, and he has it. So Loyola Marymount goes to their first lead of the ball game, 31-30, with 10:24 remaining in the first half. This is Singleton to Roberts.
That's the way you break the press. Anytime you get the numbers to your advantage, you've got to take it to the hole and take what the defense gives you.
Gathers. Rebounded by Roberts. Mismatch with Pierce Beamer on Chris Jackson. Roberts, defended by the 6'7", Hank Gathers, has a size advantage of 7'1". And Gathers picks up a cheap foul by pushing Stanley Roberts. And LMU can ill afford to get him in foul trouble.
Well, Chris Jackson has been handling the ball a great deal for LSU, and right here he fortunately gets away. But once you get the ball by the front men in the press, you've got to attack it. And you see, this is the way to end it, with Stanley Roberts going in with some authority. A good sign for Stanley Roberts. Hadn't been aggressive. One of the things Dale Brown decided to take him out of the lineup for.
Chris Jackson double clutches and finds the range. 9 first half points for Jackson.
I'll tell you what, he makes tough shots look easy. That was a tough shot.
Steamer, nice pass to Gathers. Hank Gathers with his 12th point. And it's a 1-point LSU lead. This is Maurice Williamson. Decides to take it to the hoop. And Maurice Williamson with his 4th point. Gathers to Kimble. Can't get the roll. Here comes LSU. Sims. Kimble from 3-point land. Off the mark. Rebounded by Williamson. The good pass to Jackson. And he's fouled by Pear Steamer. So LSU loving the pace as they said they would yesterday. But the Lions of Loyola Marymount said we'll see how they like it in the second half.
I think that's what they're going to have to find out. But as I watched LMU try to get back defensively, it appears as though the long trip they took from Los Angeles, having played a game two nights ago, has taken a bit of a toll, because I see more LMU players than Louisiana State players appearing to be tired. And the real test of that is, do you get back defensively? And I don't think that LMU Loyola has been doing a good job of that. LMU, LSU, James. It's just pretty easy to confuse that. See, Loyola Marymount's really been active. They've been taking the ball to the basket. They've gotten those fouls called on Stanley Roberts, exemplifying that. They're 11 for 16 from the foul line. They've got to continue to take it to the basket.
And they call the offensive charge. Indeed, they do. Maurice Williamson getting in the way of Tony Walker. And Q, with those two free throws by Chris Jackson, he now has 23 consecutive free throws made in the last four ball games. Williamson passes over to Krajewski. He misses. Here comes Walker to Peabody.
Great pass, good follow through by Peabody, coming, putting hard to get in that play.
And Tom Peabody, again, he was the guy you mentioned before, called the human bruise, averages 9.5 floor burns a game as he knocks that one out of bounds, and it's a five-point LSU lead with 8:24 remaining in the first half. This is Chris Knight coming in for the Lions, replacing Jeff Fryer.
Knight's in the game, primarily a shot blocker. He's been the guy that gets in. He's going to try to help a little bit on the inside play that has been so dominant thus far by LSU.
He's a 6'9 sophomore from Los Angeles, California, string bean player, who really does need to get a little stronger.
Needs to be stronger, but he uses his agility to his benefit. He knows he's not strong enough to muscle anybody, so he tries to...
Roberts really enjoying the size advantage on the inside as he drops in yet another basket. 6-6 from the floor. This is Steamer. Roberts with the rebound. Jackson to Sims.
Player like Chris Jackson, it makes a big difference. Jackson beat the press by himself.
And Tony Walker right back down the court to score, cutting the LSU lead to 7.
I said it all along, the thing that you have to be concerned about what LMU does to you coming back on the other end. Tony Walker, the newcomer, and everybody on the Loyola's team is pleased with Tony Walker because he brings the speed at the point guard position, much more so than they had last year. That time, Walker doing a good job taking it to the basket, looking at the three-point play.
Foul will assess that time to Maurice Williamson, his third. And Tony Walker finds the range for the three-point play, cutting the LSU lead to 6. It's a 44-38 Tigers lead.
If you ever had a chance with Nadia, this is it.
What a loser.
Guys,
she said it.
I love you. There's just some things you need to learn.
Well, this is the female form.
You have to give her what she's never had.
Yeah.
I'm getting kind of antsy.
You guys are pathetic.
American Pie, this month on DirecTV.
This month, the comedy march is on. It's springtime, a time for romance to blossom. But for this couple, a fragrance once so sweet has turned sour.
You know there's a chance that you make it to Chef.
We need a room.
Love stinks. To make it in Hollywood.
Butter, this stuff is butter.
You need money, brains, and a whole lot of luck. These guys have none of that.
It's all good. It's Cheeky Baby.
Bullfinger. He's loyal, obedient, doing what he was trained to do.
Can you go into a mini-mart and pick up a six-pack of beer?
Jim Belushi is back in K-911. The Hood, where a boy will become a man. And a man will become toast if he doesn't show up to his wedding.
Don't make me get crazy.
The Wood. The fireworks begin when three strangers light up a lonely woman's life in Sparkler. How these guys ever became superheroes sure is a mystery.
Wow.
William H. Macy, Greg Kinnear, Ben Stiller, Janine Garofalo in Mystery Men. This month on Direct Ticket, only on DirecTV.
ESPN Classic. Are you old school?
The rising sun has been our inspiration for 150 years at Folgers. On the horizon, whole new coffees are brewing. Because the most important morning of all is tomorrow's. From our last 150 years to our next, the best part of waking up.
This is ESPN Classic.
And working on LMU right now is LSU, holding a 6-point lead, and thus far, what the players have had to say about this pace, they love. The Tigers are playing well. Sims powering on the inside. Now, Wayne Sims played at the center spot for two seasons, so he's accustomed to the physical play inside.
Well, he kind of, you know, enjoys that to the extent that he'll go in and try to get a little contact when he makes a basket.
Kimble gets his own rebound and is fouled by Stanley Roberts, his second personal foul. Stanley Roberts on a training regimen trying to lose some weight. And Kansas in a close affair with Oklahoma. And earlier today right here on CBS, you saw that Big East matchup between Georgetown and St. John's. Boy, St. John's, again, looking impressive, playing a good Georgetown squad, of course, but St. John's a surprise so far.
Well, they have been surprised. You know, Jason Williams is playing well, and, you know, they've been, Wordman, all of those guys have come together, but this is a team that Louis really likes. He likes the way his team's come together, and they've done an outstanding job. We had a backcourt here by Duvall.
And the problem there is Duvall left with his feet having been stationed in the backcourt when he caught the ball.
Well, what you can see is he started on the front court and then he caught the ball going in the backcourt. So what they consider is your last point of possession was in the front court. The official made the appropriate call.
10th LSU turnover. This is Paris Beamer. Rebounded by Gathers off the mark. And Duvall does a nice job of blocking out underneath. Duvall trying to lob it to Roberts. Back to Singleton.
That's a great pass by the big fella. Stanley Roberts still learned how to play, but a great pass to get it in.
And good defensive hustle by Vernell Singleton as the ball goes off the hands of Tom Peabody. It's a 10-point LSU lead. And LSU with 10 turnovers, but expected in a high-paced contest like this.
Well, LMU, as a matter of fact, causes about 25 turnovers a game, so I'm sure they like that.
LSU with its biggest lead of the game, a 12-point lead over the Lions. Gathers goes up strong to cut it back to 10.
We got 6 minutes to go in the game, and this is, they all, there's 50 points already been scored by the LSU Tigers. That's a little bit of the sign of the game.
And the 11th turnover for the Tigers. Peabody rebounded by Walker. Fryer off the glass. So Jeff Fryer drops in his 8th point of the first half, averaging 20 points in the season. It's a 50-42 LSU lead with 5:46 remaining. Jackson kisses it off the glass.
You know, he got that move because most of the LSU's players were too tired to get down court, giving Jackson a lot of freedom on that end of the court.
Walker back to Fryer. Fryer misses his second attempt from three-point land. Q, you said you thought Chris Jackson might score 40 today. He's got 15 in the first half.
Well, he'll get a lot of points. He's a lot like Isaiah. They play well in these open court contests. Chris Jackson will get a lot of shots he doesn't normally get during conference play, that's for sure.
Fryer. And Wayne Sims is getting a lot of shots. He's got 12 points, averaging only 9 on the season. Duvall gets the roll. And a 14-point lead.
That's a sign of tired legs right there. Stanley Roberts just reached in and tried to stop Hank Gathers with a hand. You can't do that. Can't move his leg. He's just tired.
And Randy Duvall is laboring up the court. He's asked Dale Brown for a substitute. Not accustomed to this pace. And he gets his wish as Harold Boudreaux comes into the game, for
Tigers.
Randy Duvall.
If I had an oxygen company here, I think we'd do well, because you see Randy Duvall needs a little break. Right here, he takes the ball to the basket. It takes a lot of energy to try to explode off your feet to get that shot in, And once the ball goes in the basket, look at the effort it takes for the ball to get back in. Coach, help! Please help me! Get me out of here!
You see, he gets the break.
They're trying to help him over there.
What they need is some oxygen. Tapped in by Harold Boudreau.
Fresh legs.
And 6'9 height. Back to a 14-point lead for the Tigers. Kimble shot blocked by Singleton. And Stanley Roberts trying to show his ball handling. Knocked out of bounds by LMU. It'll be LSU's ball. Well, I think we'll see these numbers change drastically, of course. Hank Gathers with 16 points. Chris Jackson with 15 in the first half. Gathers averaging 27. Jackson averaging 28.
Well, I'm sure you see that Bo Kimble will come alive here shortly, but what it has been indicative of, both teams have been able to run up and down. Chris Jackson taking advantage on one end. Hank Gathers on the other.
Steamer steals it from Roberts. Gathers.
That's a fine. That's a good find by Tony Walker to find Hank Gathers all alone under the basket.
Gathers working both ends of the floor extremely well, Quinn.
Oh! Well, he was the leading rebounder as well as scorer in the country, and the reason he can do that is because his ability to get up and down the court.
And Roberts will tell you he intended to kiss it off the glass. And Terrell Lowry hammered. And Stanley Roberts is the one arguing. And if it is a foul on him, it will be his third personal foul, and it is.
Tired leg fouls, JB. You got a little guy in there. Terry Lowry is only 6'2". Roberts is 7 feet tall. Couldn't get off the ground. That time he got called for the foul just because he didn't have the leg strength to get over and get the rebound.
John O'Connell into the contest for LMU as Richard Krajewski replaces Stanley Roberts, a 6'9 junior from Grafton, North Dakota. Same hometown, or make that same state as Dale Brown.
Well, both coaches at this point are just trying to give players some breathers. You obviously got Roberts with a foul, so Krajewski is in the game. O'Neal already has three himself. On the other side, O'Connell is new, getting involved into the LMU system. It's just good to be able to get him an opportunity. But Westhead knows you've got to play a lot of people when you play at this pace.
Terrell Lowry, who has a brother, Josh Lowry, playing at the University of Portland in the same conference as LMU. The West Coast Conference nails both free throws, and it's a 12-point LSU lead, 60-48. LSU's big men are in foul trouble.
Americans love power. And they love their high-performance Briggs & Stratton engines. That's why just about every neighborhood in America is a Briggs & Stratton neighborhood. Briggs & Stratton. The power that works for you.
Burger King introduces a new twist on the Whopper. The Bacon Cheddar Whopper. Crispy bacon and melted cheddar cheese with a great flame broil taste of a Whopper.
Gentlemen, we have re-entry in T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7.
The Bacon Cheddar Whopper. Available on Earth for a limited time only, so grab one today.
Scars are a history of a life, of a game, of a place. Scars may fade or be smoothed out, but the story behind them is permanent. The NHL on ESPN, this is the game.
This is ESPN Classic.
Back here at the arena, nicknamed the Death Dome, James Brown along with Quinn Buckner, and it's a 12-point LSU lead, and Quinn,
The big men for LSU have played extremely well, combining for 20 points, but they're in foul trouble. Do you think LMU was a little concerned about that?
Well, no, I really don't think so, because LMU, Loyola wants to run up and down the court, and when you have big players, as LSU does, they can be foul prone because they get tired, can't get over in good position. That's why Paul Westhead wanted this kind of offense, because he realized he didn't have the players of stature to play the post-up kind of basketball game.
Well, the Lions players immensely confident, saying that they felt their pace would wear LSU down in the second half. Now, Dale Brown gambling with Shaquille O'Neal back in the game. He gets his own rebound and scores. Now, that's his 8 point.
But you're right, JB. That is a big gamble to come back in with Shaquille O'Neal now, because he's subject to get his fourth foul.
Right now, he gets yet another rebound and an outlet pass to Chris Jackson.
And that
touchdown.
Was a great outlet pass. I mean, he threw it over everybody right to Chris.
Gathers. And Shaquille O'Neal was lucky that time the foul was assessed to Randy Duvall.
You want to teach a big man to get the ball and look down court right away. You see, well timed over the defense's head. Great outlet pass by the young player Shaquille O'Neal. He's got great skills, got some things to learn, but he's going to be a player to be dealt with in the future, unquestionably.
Wes Unseld will give him aid on that outlet pass. Wes Unseld, of course, one of the masters at that outlet pass in the NBA for years.
Well, the thing about Shaquille is, you see, he's got 10 points, 8 rebounds. I mean, 8 rebounds, 8 points, 10 rebounds. This kid doesn't really know how to play, James. He's just learning, and he makes that pass just on instinct.
Scouts are drooling already. Hank Gavis hoping to have them drooling as he knocks in the second free throw. He's got 19 first half points. And Kimble knocking the ball out of bounds, but it stays LSU. Wayne Sims, Chris Jackson, Randy Duvall, Vernell Singleton, and Shaquille O'Neal, the five for LSU.
Good ball handling crew in for LSU. LMU basically split their starting lineup.
And a 5 second call again, as Wayne Sims was trying to get O'Neal to come to him to use that height advantage to throw the ball up to him.
Well, not only that, you can see right there, Dale Brown was telling his senior most player, even though he's a junior, Wayne Sims, call timeout if you can't get the ball in. Don't give us a turnover.
And that's exactly what they got, their 13th turnover of the first half. And Kimble loses the ball off of his foot, argues with the official. The officials today are from the Atlantic 10, Art McDonald, Tom Lopes, and Mark DeStayola. Well, this time, Wayne Sims calls a timeout as opposed to incurring a 5 second call. LSU comfortably ahead.
A 60 horsepower CL Type S from Acura.
Good evening, sir. Your finest table.
Reservation.
Perhaps you'll find it under Washington.
George Washington?
Sir, that's only a dollar. Only a dollar. Don't you know that with 10-10-220, all calls up to 20 minutes are only 99 cents, and just 7 cents a minute after that. Plus, there's no monthly fee.
Great rates and no monthly fee?
All day, every day. Oh, 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 oh.
Walk this way.
Dial 1010-220.
Soccer fans, get ready for great MLS action. When you order MLS ESPN Shootout, you'll get up to 100 matches you can't see anywhere else. So bring the action home. Order now. Call your cable company, DirecTV, or Dish Network.
This is ESPN Classic.
Back here at the Maravich Assembly Center, and LSU trying to break. Vernell Singleton has the ball slapped out of his hands by Bo Kimble.
Yeah, but you know what? Loyola doesn't mind letting that happen, because what Loyola really wants to do is get the ball back. That time they knocked the ball out, but that time what I really think they really want to do is get the ball in, get it on the other end, James. That's all.
Gathers, good rebound. Up to Lowry. This is Fryer. And he scores from three-point land. So Jeff Fryer starting to heat up just a bit. He's got 11 first-half points. It's a 64-52 LSU lead with 2:50 remaining in the first half.
You know, the one player that I would worry about if I was Dale Brown and didn't know any better would be Chris Jackson. He's played the entire half here so far, and he's had to handle the ball a great deal of the time.
Hopefully he is watching him. He said yesterday he didn't think Chris would get tired at this pace at all. Sims. First miss for Sims. He's 6 of 7, but follow up by Vernell Singleton. His 7th point. And a foul whistle against Chris Jackson. His first personal foul.
Boy, I'm telling you, he is a competitor.
Intense.
James, yesterday in practice, I watched him go down court a couple times. He didn't think his teammates were into it. He's basically a shy individual in that he's not demonstrative. But all of a sudden, he's, let's go, guys. Let's get into it. You could see he was getting fired up yesterday for this afternoon's contest.
When he speaks, they listen. 7 points, 3 assists for this young man at the free throw line, Terrell Lowry. Keeping pace with what he did last year.
Yeah, he really is. And even though the numbers may be a little different than they were last year, James, he's got a better supporting cast. And the thing that he's really learned to do is give it to the big man. They give it back to him. So he had to learn, did Chris, to move without the basketball.
Said it's a lot easier on him this year, of course, as one would expect with this kind of supporting cast. A little trouble getting the ball up court with this aggressive press by LMU. And I tell you, Q, and looking in the eyes and faces of the Lions, nobody seems tired from Loyola Marymount.
James, they do this every day in practice. I mean, and as I said, Tony Walker said, look, guys, this is the easy part of our season. The tough part is just getting through practice. No, they're not going to get tired, or they won't show it nearly as quickly as anybody else.
Shaquille O'Neal, dish pass to Jackson, and Jackson with the baseline jumper for his 19th first half point. And LMU throws it away. So LSU doing a good job of transitioning back from offense to defense.
But you see a bit of the skills right here of the young player Shaquille O'Neal getting the ball to Jackson, but I just think that all of a sudden LMU has gotten a little bit out of sync.
Duvall had the ball stolen from behind, gathers with the slam.
And that's how quick they can get back in the sink.
21 points on that slam by Hank Gathers. I think the scouts have to be impressed with him.
Well, they've got to be impressed with his ability to run the court. I think that's the most impressive thing I've seen in this contest.
68-56 lead by LSU as Chris Jackson twists an ankle on the foot of a player.
And he's down.
Now, that would be a serious blow for LSU. Let's see how bad the twist was. So often you see players trying to make a move like that and watch him get his foot caught up, but he looks to be walking okay.
Well, he goes right here. It looks as though he just gets his foot tangled up. And all that happens was Hank Gathers just didn't get there in time. And once Jackson hit Hank Gathers' foot, the next person's foot he hit was Peabody, and he just lost his footing. And you see, he's up playing, so he seemed to be all right.
1:13 remaining in the first half, a 14-point Tigers lead. Bill Brown said the only game plan he had in place today was for the players to have fun. And Peabody with a left-handed shot. LSU has a chance to tie in the first half, the most points scored in a half ever with 72. They've got 70, and Wayne Sims, smartly, not able to get the ball inbounds again, calls a timeout.
Dale would rather not have to have that timeout used, but he did. Wayne Sims did the only thing to do under the circumstances.
Faster than a speeding bullet.
Doesn't that seem a little dangerous?
More powerful than a locomotive.
We're gonna die!
Able to leap tall buildings in a single bound.
Right, that's the part that really doesn't work for me.
It's Action Heroes, all month long on Direct Ticket. He may be number one with the ladies, but when it comes to courage, he's the 13th Warrior. How these guys became superheroes is anybody's guess. Greg Kinnear, William H. Macy, Ben Stiller, Janine Garofalo in Mystery Men. Scott Glenn is a lawman who shoots first and asks questions later. The Last Marshal. The heat is on.
That didn't work. Do you think so?
Cuba Gooding Jr. and Skeet Ulrich in Chill Factor. For superstar Eddie Murphy, when the going gets tough, the tough hire a stuntman. Bowfinger. Being an action hero, it's a tough business.
I don't want to do this anymore.
Now playing on Direct Ticket, only on DirecTV.
UFC heavyweight champion Kevin Randleman.
Anybody that fights me, you're gonna pay.
Undefeated Brazilian Pedro Rizzo.
Rizzo again.
In the toughest full contact event in sports today.
Let's get it all!
Kevin Randleman versus Pedro Rizzo for the UFC Heavyweight Championship of the World. UFC 24, Friday, March 10, live on Direct Ticket. ESPN Classic.
Before your next flight, call TWA and ask for First Up, a program that puts business travelers in first class for a full coach fare. By coach, fly first. On TWA, one mission, yours.
At Enterprise Rent-A-Car, when you call us, we don't just pick up the phone. We pick you up.
This is great.
Thank you.
Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
This is ESPN Classic.
We've got a good one here. 70-58. LSU on top of the Lions of LMU with 53 seconds remaining.
Well, the thing that's really happening here, James, is that, first of all, LMU is not shooting very well, only about 39%. But the rebounds has been what's crazy. LSU has 36 to Loyola's 19. If you don't have the ball, there's no way you can run up and down the court.
Shaquille O'Neal, for the time he's been in there, has been an absolute monster on the boards for the Tigers. And not showing any signs of fatigue, but Shaquille.
Dale Brown did a good job in getting Shaquille out of the game. I question bringing him back in with three fouls. Dale has seemed thus far to be able to get away with it.
You're looking at the shot clock to the left. There are 20 seconds remaining in the game. Make that the first half. That it seems like a game as much as it's gone fast. And Chris Jackson drops in his 21st first half point. And Kimble loses the ball out of bounds and it goes back to LSU. So LSU has tied the record for the most number of points in a half, 72 points coming against Tennessee. They've got a chance to set a new record.
End of the game.
They won't get the shot off in time. So that's the end of the first half with the score, LSU 72, LMU 58. Tim Brandt will be back with the road to the Final Four after this message and a word from your local station.
Americans love their high-performance Briggs & Stratton engines. That's why just about every neighborhood in America is a Briggs & Stratton neighborhood. Briggs & Stratton, the power that works for you.
Send your phone company a message. Join us at phonefree.com and calling long distance will be totally free. And you know something? So will you. Phonefree.com. Let freedom ring.
First, we reinvented the Roadster with the Mazda Miata. Now, we've reinvented financing with Mazda's innovative new progressive payment plan. If you qualify, Mazda's progressive payment plan will dramatically lower your payments for the first year. Mazda, re-engineering the way you buy a car. See your Mazda dealer or log on to MazdaUSA.com today for details.
A great tradition continues on ESPN2, Friday Night Fights. Join hosts Max Kellerman and Brian Kenny each week as they bring you the most exciting live fights of today. Friday Night Fights, every Friday night on ESPN2.
Take a look at Bo Kimble and Jeff Fryer. Bo Kimble only 10 points in the first half, averaging 35, the nation's leading scorer. He's got a little bit to make up. But again, with the style, the pace that the Lions play, that can be made up in a hurry. This is the half that LMU said LSU would start to fade. We'll find out if that materializes. Bo Kimble
starts off with a three-point shot, so he's got 13.
You
got
to throw it up there to get it in, and Bowie's going to try to make up for lost time.
The five for LSU, Wayne Sims, Chris Jackson, Shaquille O'Neal, Maurice Williamson, and Randy Duvall. This is Jackson.
That's when he's at his best, James. When he's coming right at you, he puts you on your heel, and it's hard for you to do anything defensively against him.
And look at LSU getting back on defense to change Fryer's mind. Coaches around the conference and the country say Chris Jackson's one of the best at shooting off the dribble as Hank Gathers drops in point number 23 for him. 74-63, LSU lead.
LSU has got to handle the ball. Right here is what LMU likes to do, get turnovers off of their full-court press.
Tony Walker gets the rebound of the Jeff Fryer miss. That's a 74-65 lead, cut to 9 points. Williamson takes it, pushes it back to 11. Walker runs and scores.
James, this is what I talked to you about last night. This is where LMU gets you. All of a sudden, Tony Walker's back in the basket before any of the players from LSU gets down, and that time, now they turn the ball over. They get you in their rhythm. That's what Loyola can do to you.
Maurice Williamson having a bit of an up and down game. He normally talks to his father, John Williamson, back in Connecticut before every game, so that really gives him a confidence boost, but he tried this morning and the line was busy.
Well, I played against Super John Williamson when he was with the New Jersey Nets as well as the Indiana Pacers. Very good player, strong shooter. His son is a good all-around ball player, more of a passer than a shooter, but has done extremely well and gets great inspiration from talking to his dad.
Ball out of bounds. There's Super John Williamson, ABA and NBA star. And let me tell you, folks, I remember calling the action for the Bullets when he played for them back in Washington. And when he gets hot, he can get hot. And his son, Maurice Williamson, averaged close to 40 points a game in high school, Wilbur Cross High School in Connecticut.
Like father, like son.
Three-point shot, Jeff Fryer. And he's starting to heat up. He's got 14 points. Back to LMU. This is Kimble. Rebounded by Gathers.
That's where Hank gets you. But I told you at halftime, we started talking about the score, that you said 14 points. I said, that's not enough. LMU has got them in their style, and as long as you're playing LMU style, they can beat you.
Indeed, that lead was not enough. It's down to four as Jackson's shot is altered. Give Pear Steamer the credit, and here comes the Lions. Tony Walker fouled by Chris Jackson. Near the conclusion of today's game, we will select the Chevrolet Most Valuable Player of the Game for each team. And in their honor, Chevrolet will donate a $1,000 scholarship to the general scholarship fund of each school. That's coming up just a little bit later this afternoon. Chris Jackson picking up his second personal foul. This is Pear Steamer. Rebounded by Duvall. Ball to Sims. Sims in and out. Here come the Lions. Can cut it to two, make it four.
You know, you wonder if some of the fatigue sets in when you see LSU miss those little shots. It's like they're just not getting up. Just that little bit of difference that gets it in the basket.
The ball to Sims. Tough pass to Stanley Roberts. But Pear Steamer apparently fouls Wayne Sims from behind, his second personal foul. Pear Steamer from Södertälje, Sweden, said that the toughest adjustment for him was, of course, the running style. Your smile.
Yes, because you got the name right.
Well, you want to try the name of his high school?
No, I leave that to you, James. You're very good with that.
Shaquille O'Neal replacing Stanley Roberts. Sims in and out. Said that he knew his role would change this year with the two impressive newcomers, freshman Shaquille O'Neal and sophomore Stanley Roberts. Roberts, of course, sat out last year, a Prop 48 kid. But Sims said that would give him a chance to shoot his jump shot a bit more, and he's been on target today.
Well, when you got somebody like O'Keele and Roberts in there to get the rebound, are you a little more anxious to take that shot because you know they'll get the rebound for you?
Bo Kimble challenging Shaquille O'Neal, and he comes up with the rebound and throws the outlet to Maurice Williamson. And Williamson avoids the charge and scores.
you try to find a way to stem the tide. The LSU has been struggling a little bit of late, but you see all five of the LMU players on the basket, and right here you see a little bit of the explosiveness of the young Mo Williamson. Takes it to the basket, looking at a three-point opportunity.
Third personal foul, repair steamer of Loyola Marymount, Maurice Williamson, a 60% free throw shooter. Has upped that average to 81% in the last five ball games, so he's worked hard in turning his game up a few notches. Stolen by LSU, Williamson. Tapped from behind by Tony Walker. And Walker and Williamson talking to each other friendly.
Well, this is like you play on the street, so they're back into their rhythm here, James.
And a rhythm it is indeed. This is O'Neal. And he's been in the rhythm from the start of the game. Rebounded by O'Neal. Baseball pass to Williamson, too strong. As Williamson runs near the top of the stadium, couldn't slow himself, but good hustle, and the fans appreciate it.
Well, they think he's up there trying to sell a little popcorn, James. That time, just a little too much effort on the part of Shaquille O'Neal, and you see Williamson just goes in the stands, not three steps, but about eight stairs into the stands trying to save the basketball.
He's got the best seat in the house on the floor. Gathers. Thought he had walked. Tight ball game between number 2 Kansas and number 9 Oklahoma. Low scoring for Oklahoma. Georgetown 74-67 went over St. John. Now that was a final score, 74-67, and the score here at halftime was 72-58. Frame of reference. Gathers off the glass.
But you see Hank still taking the ball to the basket. Got to get Shaquille O'Neal and Stanley Robertson foul trouble.
Hank Gathers has his average with 27 points with 16 minutes remaining in the game. It's an 82-74 LSU lead. Sims. Rebounded by Kimble. This is Lowry. To Gathers.
Great penetration to draw the defense there by Terry Lowry. Got O'Neal off his feet.
Chris Jackson, smooth as silk with the behind-the-back dribble. Off the mark on the jump shot, but guess who's there? Shaquille O'Neal with a double jump.
Yes! Raw power, nothing but raw power. Chris Jackson takes a shot. Paris Steamer does everything he can to keep O'Neal from the basket, but the young fella still gets it up in it, and he's excited about it. Chris struggling a little bit from outside here late, but O'Neal just takes it in there. I mean, he gets fouled. There's a choice for who you want to call for the foul, but O'Neal shovels it in the basket, having a great game.
I love the story Dale Brown tells about how he been speaking at an Army base in West Germany. 6'9 kid comes over and says, how can I work on my jumping? He says, well, soldier, how old are you? He says, I'm only 13. He says, where's your father? I want to talk to him.
A typical car insurance agent is on the job during regular business hours. On the other hand, GEICO insurance professionals are on the job 24 hours a day. GEICO, a 15-minute call could save you 15% or more on car insurance. Still paying too much for car insurance? GEICO, a 15-minute call could save you 15% or more.
Oh, that was some meatloaf.
And some heartburn.
Oh, yeah.
You want some Tums?
Well, we could try these new Pepsid AC gel caps.
Are you kidding? They aren't going to be fast like Tums. They're just as slow as regular Pepsid.
Tums calcium neutralizes acid fast. Pepsid gel caps famotidine has to go all through your bloodstream before it starts controlling acid, so it's just as slow as regular Pepsid.
Well, so you want to wait? Or you want the Tums?
Forget about it. There's the Tums.
The Rick, this is Sean with ESPN Fantasy Baseball. We only use stats from players in the AL and the NL. We do not accept stats from the RL, the Rick League. Stop faxing us your wiffle ball stats. You're jamming up our machine.
This is ESPN Classic.
Classic.
The frenetic pace with the LMU Lions leading at 85-76. And Quinn, they certainly have to be pleased with this 17-year-old youngster here. Impressive game.
Well, you know, he's got 13 points, 15 rebounds, 3 assists, but 6 block shots has just been the story here this afternoon all over the court. You've got to be impressed with the young man.
Bo Kimble nails a 3-pointer. He's got 16 points on the afternoon. O'Neal up to Singleton. Looking strongly just to control the ball. Chris Jackson is Terrell Lowry. Smart move by Chris Jackson as Lowry picks up his third personal foul, just staying there to exaggerate the point that there's a foul.
You don't teach this. Chris Jackson knows the right thing to do is to go to the basketball. That time he got the foul call on Lowry just by being smart enough. Go to the ball, make the defense go through you.
Jackson taking the one-on-one challenge and scoring. Both the ball comes out. And O'Neal touches it on the rim. Now, Quinn, that ball had actually gone down into the rim and come back out.
Fisher's got a good position. You see, Jackson stops where he should. Now, watch the ball will come off the rim, and it'll barely be on the tip of it, and you'll see O'Neal's hand right up there near it. There's no question. It's still on the rim. Even though it's coming out, O'Neal just had his hand on the ball while it's on the rim.
But that's a shooter's touch where the ball just hangs on the rim like that. Blocked by Shaquille O'Neal, who now has just set a single-season shot-blocking record with 62 block shots.
Well, I think Hank Gathers is making a mistake by trying to shoot jump shots over O'Neal. I think you can take it to the basket on O'Neal, but you can't shoot jump shots 7 foot against 6'7".
Terrell Lowry with the three-pointer. So a new LSU single-season shot-blocking record by Shaquille O'Neal. And smartly tapping the court to Chris Jackson.
Well, you know why we've been here admiring these guys, and it's been a great game. Do you notice LMU is right back in the game?
Tap in attempt by Vernell Singleton. LSU ball. New shot clock. 14 minutes remaining in the game. 85-82 lead, and you're right, Quinn. Only a 3-point Tiger lead as well as the Tigers are playing.
Well, yes, because LMU can get you again in their rhythm. That's what they've been able to do. All of a sudden, you're taking quick shots. Loyola pushes it down, gets it on the other end.
Vernell Singleton with his 9th point. Gathers. Blocked by Singleton. Great defensive play.
Great effort.
Williamson. Blocked by O'Neal. Stolen and slammed by Hank Gathers. So O'Neal picks up his 8th block of the game, his highest for the season, 10 in a single game. Williamson answers with a 3. Kimble scores and is fouled by Randy Duvall. So Duvall showing signs of fatigue, probably needing a break.
Well, I think not only Duvall, but Shaquille O'Neal has got to be showing signs of it. What has really been a good job, I think, on the part of Dell Brown is the thing you need to do. You can't afford to try to get O'Neal up and down the court every time. So when O'Neal feels that he's out of the play, going to the offensive end, he stays back, has been playing great defense. All of a sudden, LMU is having some trouble getting the ball in the basket. They're turning into fast break for LSU.
So the 5 for LMU, Pear Steamer, Bo Kimble, Jeff Fryer, Terrell Lowry, and Chris Knight. And there's a conversation taking place at the scorers table involving Dale Brown. Apparently, we've got a clock malfunction here.
13
and Quinn, I tell you, I remember the first football game that I ever called, talking about not calling action literally from the clock. I remarked that there were 8 minutes and 99 seconds remaining in the third quarter, and every camera person in the world turned around, and now there's 13:99 remaining.
Well, I can tell you what, I'm sure LSU, even though they're ahead, they don't need 13:99 on the clock, because that means you don't know when this game might end, and that just means they've been worn out running up and down this court.
Well, Quinn, just to elaborate on your point again, an impressive game by Shaquille O'Neal, who's been the difference, a big man getting up and down the floor, but the Lions of Loyola Marymount only down by 6 points.
Well, as I've said, and you and I have talked about this, Loyola is into the game that they absolutely enjoy. They don't have the luxury to all of a sudden go to a half-court game, so they want to keep the tempo up and down. LSU, on the other hand, has great potential and is showing very good signs of their potential by being able to push the ball up and down the court, being successful, as well as go inside to their big people having success. Therefore, they have a six-point lead right now.
Loyola Marymount players said they were only surprised by one other team that had a few big players who could keep up with this pace, and that was Xavier, the team they lost to. Thus far, the Tigers doing an excellent job of that as Bo Kimble drops in his 19th point of the game. Down to a five-point Tiger lead is Stanley Roberts, who's in the game. The safety valve. Got to get it across the 10-second line, and Duvall does. Williamson. Lob to Singleton. Fryer answering right back with the three. That was not the perfect lob, and Singleton had to go up another notch.
And get it left-handed.
And Roberts with another one. But here comes LMU. Lowry, racehorse basketball.
Going up and down, James. I got a little bit of tennis neck. I don't know about you.
The players said they needed their rest. We needed ours as well. As Chris Jackson is fouled by Chris Knight.
Things go well for you. They go extremely well. Williamson, knowing that he's got Stanley Roberts coming, but Vernell gets this one. You know, the thing about Vernell is that he's played the inside position, thoroughly enjoys getting in there and banging around. That time he had the chance to show some of his jumping ability.
John O'Connell replaces Paris Steamer. You know who Vernell Singleton's favorite hero is at the NBA level? Adrian Dantley says he loves his work ethic, and certainly there's no one who works any harder and gets more out of his ability than Adrian Dantley.
Well, having played on the Olympic team with Adrian, I'd have to agree with him.
Roberts on the tip end. This is Fryer for three. Rebounded by Kimble. Runs into Roberts, loses the ball, but they say Lions basketball. Up and down action, 12:02 remaining, and only a six-point LSU lead.
90 years ago, fans thrilled to the exploits of baseball's power hitters, who belted as many as 9, 10, or even 12 homers a season. The game has changed, and so has the way we watch it, with MLB Extra Innings on DirecTV Sports. Tune to Channel 243 and catch the 2000 MLB Extra Innings season for just $129. This year, one of these guys could hit number 12 by May 12. Be there with MLB Extra Innings.
Do you want great entertainment?
Yeah, I guess so.
Just do the spring thing.
Just go with it.
And catch a hit.
I like the way this man thinks.
On DirecTV, a young woman's fancy turns to flight. Richard Gere.
You're the only one for me.
Julia Roberts.
And that's romantic.
Runaway Bride. It's open season on This Bachelor.
I'm afraid I should make you a very bad husband.
I don't mind bad husbands. I've had two.
An ideal husband. Antonio Banderas goes from a lamb.
I am not a warrior.
To a lion. The 13th Warrior. These superheroes don't have a clue.
I'm invisible. Can you see me?
Yes.
But they'll grow on you.
Wow.
Mystery Men. For this group of Hollywood hacks. Everything's coming up roses.
You're gonna be a star.
Steve Martin. Eddie Murphy. Bowfinger. Will these guys ever blossom into adulthood?
Don't give up the best thing that ever happened to you because you're scared.
Find out in The Wood when you want to watch the hottest from Hollywood.
Good heavens.
Just do the spring thing.
Doesn't that seem a little dangerous, though?
And catch a hit movie this month on DirecTV.
Tonight on ESPN at 7:30 Sports Center. At 8, the Red Wings skate with the Stars. And at 11, the Late Sports Center. On ESPN2, women's college basketball at 5, the SEC Championship, followed at 7 by the Big Ten Championship, and at 9, College Hoops Tonight. And on ESPN Classic at 7, Click and Pick. At 9, this week's edition of Real Classics, and at 11, Michael Jordan takes a swing at baseball. Do you have all the ESPN networks?
Oh, I just made it.
Yes, you did.
Ever get the feeling some people just stop trying? At Avis, we know a couple minutes can make all the difference. That's why with our preferred service, you can skip the counter and go straight to your car.
This is ESPN Classic.
LSU lead as Fryer misses the three-point attempt. And Fryer comes out of the thicket with the ball. And a whistle. A down LSU player.
Well, there's a lot of scrambling in there, and Dale Brown is trying to tell the official that the play was getting a little too aggressive.
And it looks like Maurice Williamson caught an elbow in the mouth that time as he still has yet to get up.
Free ball, everybody's got a right for it, and you see right here, Williamson goes for the ball, and I don't think there's anything intentional there. It's just a free ball, and with that, everybody has a right to it. Lowry's the guy that got him, but again, when the ball is free, the wise thing to do is just go for it.
So Dale Brown upset with the kind of physical play underneath the basket has just received a technical foul. And so Dale now employs the John Chaney stare down.
I haven't seen that get anybody an extra free throw or anything since I've been watching this. But it looks as though that Maurice Williamson's all right.
And Quinn, I tell you, Dale is really pacing and staring down the officials.
In a scramble, everybody goes for the ball. You see it go up, and you see an arm comes down on his head. It's Terry Lowry, and there's no question that it's an unintentional foul. You know, Dale Brown is just commenting, I'm sure, that the play is being aggressive. But if he had the luxury of our replay, he would see that that was not an intentional foul.
Put him in.
Well, Dale Brown is Mike. Let's give a listen.
Know he's got. Wait. For Harold, you take the ball out.
The substitution you just heard. Wayne Sims coming in for Harold Boudreau as Bo Kimble goes to the free throw line, keeping in mind now all technical fouls this year call for two free throws as Kimble, an 83% free throw shooter, misses the first. One of two for Bo Kimble, and it's a 5-point Tigers lead. Gabbers operating on Stanley Roberts. And Hank Gabbers not afraid to take the 7'1" Roberts down low and operate on him.
But you saw what he did that time, James. He took him on the move. That's the thing you got to do with this Stanley Roberts. You can't stand still.
And give Terrell Lowry the credit as Chris Jackson picks up his third personal foul, a frustration foul. Lowry was the one who knocked the ball loose from behind.
Yeah, and when you're playing in your guard like Chris Jackson, you're as disappointed in yourself as anybody else because you didn't recognize the pressure coming from the backside that time, and his anxiousness to get back in the play, Chris Jackson got the call.
That Dale Brown stare down as much recognizing that Loyola Marymount nowhere near out of this game. It's only a 3-point Tigers lead. Loyola's shooting has improved to spell the difference as Pear Steamer picks up his fourth personal foul. Terrell Lowry out, Tony Walker back in, and Sims still having difficulty getting it in, and Fryer steals it and scores.
That's the bad decision, JB. All of a sudden he threw the basketball, but nobody from LSU was there.
The fourth time today that Sims has had difficulty getting the ball inbounds. Bo Kimble picks up a personal foul trying to defend Chris Jackson, his second personal foul. And Quinn, it's a 1-point Tigers lead with 11-13 remaining in the game.
If you're Paul Westhead, you have to like where you are. Bo Kimble is starting to come alive a little bit. Fryer's hit a couple of three-pointers. You're still in the game, and in spite of the fact the first half you only shot 36%. If you're Paul Westhead and the LMU Lions, you've got to feel good about where you are right now.
We asked Paul Westhead what kind of game plan would he have in place today for the big guys of LSU.
The same one I employ all the time.
He said, well, what about checking Chris Jackson?
He said, I'm not changing. I'm running the same thing I run all the time. I've been running. I'm going to run. I don't care who we play against.
Chris Jackson, 25.6 assists. We'll find out whether or not Maurice Williamson will be able to return. Williamson, of course, got hit in the nose, and we're not certain that he's going to return as there's a turnover by the Lions, and it goes to LSU. Full-court press employed by the Lions, and Bo Kimble starting to struggle a little bit as he runs up the court. Randy Duvall kisses it off the glass, and it's a five-point Tigers lead. Here comes Fryer, trying to cut it to two. Rebounded by O'Neal. Jackson.
That's a little pop shot right there. Stop right inside the paint. Pop it up.
You know, what may look like a helter-skelter offensive set for Loyola Marymount is really under control, as Paul Westhead has his players running to certain spots.
I was going
to
say exactly that. It's controlled chaos, if you will. Understanding the players really want to run, what Paul Westhead has decided to do is give everybody a spot to run to. Fryer on the right side, Bo Kimble on the left side at the three-pointer.
Randy Duvall with the three-pointer.
Making Dale Brown look like a genius is Randy.
Check it. That was a two-point shot by Randy Duvall. Gathers. Using the basket to block O'Neal. And it's a four-point LSU. Duvall. Kimble. And the pace seems to have slowed a bit for Loyola Marymount. Yes.
Oh, no, you think it's slow? This game is zooming.
Slow by comparison. Not that shot by Jeff Fryer. A three-point shot by Fryer. His sixth three-point shot of the game. He said he had the green light in high school. An easy transition here. And there's a turnover. Now, that is a sign that Loyola Marymount is looking for.
Clearly a sign of fatigue. That pass that time was thrown by Randy Duvall. It was thrown right out of bounds.
Loyola Marymount has enjoyed a lot of success running up the points. 100 points scored 17 times this season as Maurice Williamson comes back in for LSU. A good sign. And I'm sure his father is glad to see that. Fryer from two-point range.
Well, they got him back in on Jeff Fryer, so Maurice Williamson's got his hands free.
Fryer is part of that trio that averages 82 points a game for Loyola Marymount.
Going to be tough to replace that next year, but at this point, Paul Westhead's willing to take his chance.
O'Neal showing his strength again, almost making another double clutch.
Almost making that shot. He's laughing because the shot almost went in, but Just trying to make sure that a foul or the ball didn't get in the basket. Chris Knight got in here in such a hurry, but O'Neal is so strong. Again, great feed by Chris Jackson, and you see the big fella try to take it up strong. Kept his eye on the basket. That's the key. Kept his eye on the target. Almost got it in.
7'1", 286 pounds, 17 years old, wears a size 19. Now, you played with Bob Lanier, the Dobber.
The Dobber.
Who allegedly wore a 19, but Quinn, I saw when I visited St. Bonaventure as a junior, I saw 22 inscribed in that shoe, a size 22 for Lanier.
You know, and this was, I agree with you, but back in the early, this is like the early 80s, I played with Alton Lister. The funniest thing happened to us, we're going to a game and Lister leaves his shoe and he asks Bob Lanier, can I borrow your shoe? A size 22.
A lot of room to swim. Blocked by O'Neal. Eighth block. Charging foul on Tony Walker.
Again, Shaq is all over the court. He blocked it on that end, and Chris is too tough a guard here. He just shakes up both of the LMU players, and then they push it back down on the other end. Defensively, again, Shaquille O'Neal stopping it on the other side.
Chris Jackson operating 1-on-3 that time, averaging 28 points. He's got 29 with 8 minutes and 13 seconds remaining. Singleton. Rebounded by Walker. And Tony Walker gets called for the charging foul, and Quinn, Walker arguing, and he may have a good case.
Well, I would have to agree with him, but Paul Westhead wisely just kind of backs off, said, fellas, let it go.
CBS Sports coverage of NCAA basketball will continue after this word from your local station.
There's only one way to fly on business, and that's first class, which is why TWA created First Up, a program that puts you in first class for a full coach fare. It's that simple. By coach, fly first. Before your next flight, call TWA and ask for First Up and see if there's a first class seat waiting for you. By coach, fly first. First Up from TWA. One mission, yours.
Discover the amazing training secrets of America's finest baseball school in an exciting instructional video. Baseball World's Defensive Drills video features professional scout and instructor Tommy Mansky and the same techniques that produced his back-to-back-to-back AAU national championship teams. Collegiate Baseball Magazine's editor calls it a masterpiece, the best drill video ever produced. This video is endorsed by top professionals like superstar Fred McGriff.
This is the instructional video that gets results.
The Defensive Drills video benefits players of all ages and ability levels and makes a great gift too, so call now.
Scars are a history of a life, of a game, of a place. Scars may fade or be smoothed out, but the story behind them is permanent. The NHL on ESPN, this is the game.
This is ESPN Classic.
You're watching LSU versus Loyola Marymount from February 3rd, 1990 here on ESPN Classic. Due to time constraints, we now move ahead in the ballgame.
126-114, LSU on top, 4:31 remaining in the contest.
Shaquille O'Neal has been the story. He's been blocking shots, rebounding, done everything. He's got a triple-double, 16 points, 18 rebounds, 10 block shots, rebounds and block shots, the big ones.
And Sims, it's an experience every time he takes the ball out of bounds. Randy Duvall, too high to Singleton. Needed Sherman Douglas for that pass. Bo Kimble.
Got time to get his feet under him, J.B. He's able to get that one in.
And 26 points after scoring only 10 in the first half. Jackson for three. In and out. Loyola Marymount's ball. Paul Westhead still keeping the feel of the game. Three-point field goal shooting by LMU. He's got him back into the game, trailing by seven.
They warmed up a little bit in the second half, but the problem is they just can't get enough going on the inside. Shaquille O'Neal has just taken all of that play away from
him. PGA golf coming up next to AT&T. Pebble Beach National Pro-Am. And a three-point shot scored by Terrell Lowry. Lowry has 20 points and stolen and scored by Jeff Fryer.
Duvall,
and it's down to a two-point game.
Duvall lost his place on the court. Didn't realize he was under the basket, tried to pass it. Hit the rim.
Fryer, 8 points over his average of 20. A 126-124 lead by LSU with 3:16 remaining. Singleton pushes it back up to a four-point lead. He's got 18. Gathers continuing to challenge the big men as he scores the hoop and has fouled. 39 points scored so far by Hank Gathers.
The strength of Hank Gathers is to get the ball on the move. You got O'Neal waiting for him to come in. You see, coming from the left of your screen, there's a foul by Randy Duvall. But there have been some good things happen for Hank Gathers. He struggled a little bit because at one point he passed out on the foul line. He went to the doctor, they ran tests. He seems to be all right. He's been on some medication. He scored 44 points in that game the other night where he got 154. They had backed off some of the medication. This is not a fluke that he's starting to score so well. That medication obviously was slowing him down. You see now he's got 40 points in this game.
Only the second player in NCAA history to lead the nation in scoring and rebounding last season. Noah Williamson back into Singleton. Vernell Singleton, 14 points over his average of six as Gathers continues to rack it up with his 42nd point. And it's a one-point ball game with 2:41 remaining. LSU on top, 130-129. Jackson. Blocked by Gathers. Sims fouled by Gathers. So Hank Gathers picks up his fourth personal foul.
Foul number 44, Hank Gathers. His fourth personal foul.
Wayne Sims on a conditioning program along with Stanley Roberts. Roberts runs and works out at 7 o'clock in the morning and 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Sims, having to lose a little less weight, works out only once a day at 7 o'clock in the morning, trying to lose 10 pounds. He's lost 5 already.
Well, he played a lot inside, so they wanted to put weight on him last year. This year, they moved him out a little bit or a little more often, so they wanted to take some of that weight off of Wayne Sims.
Don't forget, golf coming up next at the conclusion of this track meet here between LSU and LMU. Gathers kisses it off the glass. He's on fire.
He's back.
And again, we talked about how he wanted to impress the scouts. Quinn, absolutely no question about his ability to play well at the next level. 18 of 31 from the floor.
And when I talked to him yesterday, it was important for him to play well. He knew that there were some people wondering or doubting his ability, so he wanted to get a good contest today.
Shaquille O'Neal powering his way in.
Too easy, JB. In there, he'll score all day.
18 points for the Shaq. 1:46 remaining, a 3-point Tigers lead. Gavins blocked by O'Neal. 11th block. And a foul called on Tony Walker, who's upset, saying that Maurice Williamson used that left hand pushing out like his father did at the NBA level.
Well, right away you take the ball into Shaquille O'Neal. The problem was Hank Gathers had him out on the court. He should have just tried to beat him. You go in and try to play inside with O'Neal. There's an obvious advantage to O'Neal, 7 foot to 6'7".
Timeout called on the floor. And some question as to whether or not Tony Walker fouled out. We'll answer it when we come back.
To get around these parts, they say you need dogs. Good thing I got my new Subaru Outback. It's got loads of cargo space, toasty seat warmers, and something you won't find on your average sport utility.
The added traction of full-time all-wheel drive.
It's the perfect way to get around, even when you're way out here.
Now, as for the dogs, they're not much help if you ask me.
Outback, the world's first sport utility wagon.
The King brothers, separated at birth. George King went to a family that subscribed to fishing magazines. James's family subscribed to the Wall Street Journal. 28 years later, George lives with his parents, while his brother James started a B2B web company and went public with a record first day pop. Food for thought, especially since you can get 13 weeks of the Wall Street Journal for just 57 cents a day. That's 25% off the regular rate. Call 800-443-1900. That's 800-443-1900 for the Wall Street Journal.
When I go to college, I'm going to go to UConn. I'm going to be the next Rebecca Lobo.
Yeah, well, I'm going to Kansas. I'm going to be a star, just like my man, Ryan Robertson.
I'm headed for Tennessee. I'm going to be the next Shamiqua Holdsclaw.
Hey, what's the big deal about college basketball anyway?
Because if it happens to my team,
Sunday it might happen to me.
Soccer fans, get ready for great MLS action. When you order MLS ESPN Shootout, you'll get up to 100 matches you can't see anywhere else. So bring the action home. Order now. Call your cable company, DirecTV, or Dish Network.
This is ESPN Classic.
1:26 remaining in the contest. LSU nursing a 3-point lead over Loyola Marymount. Loyola Marymount with 3 timeouts remaining, LSU with 1. And going to the commercial break, we were asking about whether or not Tony Walker had fouled out, and indeed he did pick up his 5th personal foul. He's out of the ballgame.
Well, you saw the timeout situation, but Tony Walker, what LMU loses with that is great floor speed. He didn't get it. don't get up and down the court as well without him. But with Lowry taking his place, what they get in return is a great three-point shooter. So there is a trade-off. And right now, they could use the three-point shooting because they have enough good ball handlers in the game.
Gathers, snatches the rebound. And Loyola Marymount can cut into the deficit or tie it with a three-point shot. Kimble. And it scores and is fouled. An opportunity to tie the ball game.
Well, you go to your money anytime you're in trouble. Kimble has been scoring. You see right away, he gets Ronell Singleton off his feet, a cardinal sin for a defensive player, and the scorer still gets the ball in the basket once he got Singleton off his feet.
Bo Kimble had a poor first half, dropping in only 10 points. He scored 18 in the second half, 28 points to go along with 11 rebounds. As Jeff Fryer takes a seat, Tom Peabody replaces him.
You get a little tempo upbeat here with Fryer going out of the game. With Peabody, somebody coming in, trying to poke the ball loose. With the press coming in after the made free throw, they want Peabody to try to get the ball for him.
And Kimble ties the ball game at 134 apiece. This is Singleton. Hammered by the human bruise himself. And Singleton getting a first-hand feel and understanding of why that nickname.
I'll tell you, you can't fault the kid for effort. Great effort. You'll see him come right down the middle of your screen, and he thinks that Vernell Singleton's going to take the shot. Tries to keep him from falling. But you can't fault the effort. He comes in, plays great defense. They take him out and get the shooter back in on the other end, bringing Jeff Fryer back in the game.
Vernell Singleton wearing a Band-Aid on that left shoulder of his. Said he's been scratched consistently in games prior to this one. Doesn't have a scratch there, but is wearing a Band-Aid just in case. And misses the free throw and is still tied. So an impressive showing by LSU, and the ball game is tied. Loyola Marymount right in this one. Tie ball, possession arrow favors LSU with under a minute to play in the contest.
But it's still enough time. There are 53 seconds on the clock. Still enough time that if should LSU score on this end, Loyola has an opportunity to come back and try to score on the other end.
Stanley Roberts, all 7'1" of him, comes in to replace Wayne Sims. Dale Brown looking for the rebounding strength on the offensive end.
No, but what he's doing, this is more of getting the ball in bounds. Both Roberts, one of the guys, either Roberts or Neal, has to have a smaller man guarding him, and he wanted to be able to throw it over the top to him. They were able to get it to Jackson.
48 seconds remaining. Tie ball game. Chris Jackson, Randy Duvall, Vernell Singleton, Stanley Roberts, and Shaquille O'Neal in the game. Shot clock to your left, game clock to your right. And LMU with 32 seconds remaining.
Well, you got it where you want it now. You got the ball. This is a place that is questionable where you want to take a timeout. Paul Westhead decides to do it. But you give the defense an opportunity to set up, as well as the offense, a time to figure out what they want
shot
to do.
Shot clock not a factor. 25 seconds remaining. Loyola Marymount will have the ball when we return.
You want to watch a hit movie on DirecTV, but your day's so busy you think it's not for me. You gotta drop the kids and the dog needs a walk, and when the really good part comes,
good,
that's when mama calls to talk. But just look for the all-day ticket, pay once, and when you're ready you can pick it all day till 6 a.m. Eastern. So when you're watching the show and you really gotta go, just get all-day ticket, and when you're ready you can pick it.
Gotcha.
You know what I'm saying? All-day ticket.
You know, some people might find this somewhat intense, but these guys are just warming up, because we're talking playoff stretch run, baby.
Call 1-800-GET-SPORTS and score with NHL Center Ice. You'll see up to 30 out-of-market games every week through the rest of the season for just $99. Plus, select first and second round Stanley Cup playoff games.
It's time for the game's best to pick up the pace.
It's time for you to pick up the phone.
It's NHL Center Ice on DirecTV.
This month on the new Encore Movie Channel, you'll get recent, big, hit movies. And the new Encore is the only channel that promises you a great movie every night, guaranteed. The new Encore Movie Channel, A great movie every night, guaranteed. Just one of 12 premium movie channels from Stars and Encore in the Total Choice Stars package.
If you want to see the best NCAA tournament games in history, then don't miss ESPN Classic's Tournament Time Warp. Go back in time and catch basketball's biggest stars before they made it big. Jordan, Barkley, Malone, Olajuwon, all playing for a national championship.
At the buzzer, it counts!
Revisit classic teams, buzzer beaters, and huge upsets. Get Warp with Tournament Time Warp. Starts March 12th, only on ESPN Classic.
This is ESPN Classic.
We foul 44 or 20. Now, can we come up with a steal here?
Randy, you're going to make 30, okay?
As you hear Dale Brown talking with his troops.
44 or 20, okay? 44 or 20, okay. Foul, okay?
And the two players that Dale Brown was talking about to foul.
And I'm bouncing it late through, yeah.
Hank Gathers and Terrell Lowry.
They're going
on the other end. Paul Westhead talking to his troops.
Westhead is really going to run the clock down. He wants to get it down under the 10-second mark. And at that point, you got two of the top scorers in the country on your team. You got options. You got Old Kimble, the nation's leading scorer. You got Hank Gathers, who led the nation last year. But another option you got Jeff Fryer. I would give the ball to Bo Kimble. He's able to take people off the dribble, create opportunities for somebody else.
But you would run most of the time off the clock as opposed to shooting it quickly as they normally do?
Oh, absolutely, because you don't want to give LSU time to run the clock or get it down to the other end. So
Terrell,
I would definitely run
the ball. Fouled by Chris Jackson from behind. Now, he was one of the two players that Dale Brown said to foul. Terrell Lowry, a 69% free throw shooter. Sophomore out of Oakland, California.
Clearly one of the guys you want to foul.
Hey, Chris. What's this guy?
He's going to try to ice him. Take the time out here. You try to ice the player. You send him over to the side. You want Terrell Lowry to think about these foul shots he's got to make. Gives him a chance to set up the offense on the other side for LSU.
And LSU has just burned off its last timeout with 10 seconds remaining. Tie ball game.
Kilago, alone on Kilago. How empty it seems with only my dreams.
Introducing the 3.2 CO from Acura.
Hi, I'm here in Washington, D.C. to let women know that the government has quota programs for women entrepreneurs to get money to start or expand a business.
I got over $2 million in government contracts for my training company.
Listen, women can get grants, loans, contracts, free help to start any kind of business.
How much a contract?
$199,000!
Great!
Call me and I'll show you what you can get too!
Call 1-800-754-0077. That's 1-800-754-0077. Money back guaranteed if not completely satisfied.
A great tradition continues on ESPN2, Friday Night Fights. Join host Max Kellerman and Brian Kenny each week as they bring you the most exciting live fights of today. Friday Night Fights, every Friday night on ESPN2.
This is ESPN Classic.
The packed house here at the Maravich Assembly Center in Baton Rouge, Louisiana has seen a good one. It's all tied at 134 apiece, 10 seconds remaining. Two timeouts remaining for Loyola, none for LSU. And don't forget, coming up next, the AT&T Pebble Beach National Pro-Am coming your way at the conclusion of this basketball game here. James Brown along with Quinn Buckner. And Quinn, if you're Paul Westhead, you really have to like where you are.
Well, obviously, you're on the line with two foul shots right here. You would probably assume have Bo Kimble on the line, but you got a good shooter as far as Westhead's concerned. The fans are going to help for LSU. This is a good timeout for LSU.
rebounded by Gathers. Shot missed. One second remaining on the clock, and it's LSU ball.
They don't have any timeout, so what they're probably going to try to do is try to get the big fellas inside and just try to lob it to them. Oh, Paul Westhead took a timeout because he knows what they want to do.
He's
try
got
to lob
it
into, yes, lob it into the big fella.
Rent-A-Car. When you call us, we don't just pick up the phone. We pick you up.
This is great.
Thank you.
Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
Right. Give me a good exit to clean arcs. Go.
Come on.
Pay attention. Right. Heads up at 4,500 feet. Look. Reach. Pull. Go. Come on. You can do it. I did stay at a Holiday Inn Express last night.
Right here. Okay, pretend you guys don't do anything. Just pretend we're trying to go to you.
You line up Shaquille right here.
Stanley, you stay here. Shaquille here. Shaquille,
1 second
soon as
remaining.
Wade hits the ball, you take off. Stanley, you line up here and step down. And we're going to throw it up in the air to him, Wade.
They ain't playing him.
No.
Like that. You got to switch everything. Ball left and come
along. Yeah, switch everything. Well, the thing that you got here is you only have 1 second. So you know the lob is the most likely player. You've got to, Paul Westhead should get his biggest player he can on the ball, or his best jumper on the ball. The next thing you got to do is put a body. You've got to put a body on both O'Neal and Roberts. If you put a body on both of those guys, what it does is it negates their jumping ability because they don't have the opportunity to squat down, get a good base. So that's what you got to do. So what Paul Westhead has decided to do is put in Chris Knight, who is their best jumper on a 2 foot jump. He leaves the rest of his team in to put a body on both Shaquille O'Neal and Stanley Robinson, because it's just going to be a lot.
And he's also got his most physical player in there in Pear Steamer at 6'7", 210 on O'Neal. And the clock expires. Did they call a foul?
No.
They did not.
No.
So Stanley Roberts hit the floor. Chris Jackson asking the official if there was a foul. There is none, so we go to overtime.
You got to block the defensive player. Stanley Roberts is able to keep position, does a good job. It looks like a clean block to me. I thought Bo Kimble got over with a clean block.
So we get set for a 5 minute overtime.
Running is the fastest way to burn fat if you follow these simple steps. Running will power up your energy reserve if you know what pace is best for you. Running will trim your love handles, hips, and thighs if you call now for this free book, The Complete Runner's Guide, designed for all levels, even if you've never taken a stride. This guide delivers maximum results in minimum time. It's free with your paid subscription to Runner's World. Every issue gets you going with new ideas on improving your performance to finding the perfect shoe. Call for your risk-free trial issue of Runner's World. If you like it, get 11 more for just $17.97. If you're not satisfied, cancel, owe nothing, and keep the free issue. Call now and get a second book free. Burn fat faster. Tone your abs. Lose weight. Drop body fat. The secrets are here. You can burn fat. Gain more energy. Sculpt your body. If you call Runner's World now.
Call 1-800-213-8700 now.
You're watching LSU versus Loyola Marymount from February 3rd, 1990 here on ESPN Classic.
A track meet down south here in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. LSU and LMU all tied at 134 apiece, and we go into a five-minute overtime. And don't forget, coming up at the conclusion of this game, it'll be the AT&T Pebble Beach National Pro-Am. That coming at the conclusion of this game here. And Quinn, as you take a look at both squads going into this five-minute overtime, give me the condition of each team.
Well, the first thing you have to be concerned about are your timeouts. So Loyola has two timeouts because both teams are given timeouts in an overtime.
One additional timeout.
Exactly. So LSU has one. The next thing you got to worry about is fouls. Gathers and Steamer both have four. But on the other side, the really critical for LSU is Jackson has four as well as Duvall. So Jackson's got to be concerned about, or his coach Dale Brown has to be concerned about the fourth foul on Jackson. But going here, I would think that the momentum has to favor LMU. They've been in trouble all game, been able to catch up, and usually the team that catches up has that momentum going in their flow.
And LMU will get the first shot attempt. This is Terrell Lowry. And to Hank Gathers, who's got 44 points. And Gathers scores the first basket in overtime, the first overtime that Loyola Marymount has played this season.
Well, it's a good test for both teams, but for the young players, Shaquille and Neal, this is their third opportunity, but they haven't played a game quite this hard, this long, I'm sure, even though the others were overtime, because they just don't run that much in the contest they play.
It'll be interesting to see how strong physically Randy Duvall is. This has been a real quick pace, and several times throughout the game, he's gotten tired. Jackson, Sims, Singleton, Shaquille O'Neal, and Randy Duvall, the five for LSU.
LSU will try to take advantage of what they have inside.
Singleton. Rebounded by Pear Steamer.
A little bit of different kind of patience I thought you'd see in LMU. They're bringing it out, moving it around a little bit. That actually helps LSU get a chance to get their breath.
LMU taking quite a bit of time. This is Jeff Pryor off the front of the rim, but rebounded by Gathers. And a fresh 45 for Loyola Marymount with 3:33 remaining in overtime.
You got to wonder how much quickness to the ball has to do with just fatigue in the legs of Shaquille O'Neal.
Gathers, left-handed shot. So the first two baskets scored in overtime, both by Hank Gathers, and it's a four-point Loyola Marymount lead and a steal to the Lions. Fryer for three. And Singleton comes up with the ball. The ball for three.
Oh, that's one of the shots Dale Brown says, no, 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 good shot.
Terrell Lowry fouled by Chris Jackson.
If that's his Jackson's
that
foul, that's its fifth.
Should be his fifth personal foul. And that is number five on Chris Jackson.
He thought he had four fouls.
And you see him looking puzzled. And again,
yeah,
this is what one of the things Dale Brown was talking about, why he does not like the six foul rule that they use in the SEC play, because it hurts in non-conference play.
Well, I would agree that it hurts. But right here, Chris Jackson clearly thinks he has only three fouls. And there is no question about the foul. But Chris thinks that he has a foul to give. And Terrell Lowry, as you recall, was one of the players that Dale Brown wanted to be fouled in case there was any kind of emergency opportunity.
First, we reinvented the Roadster with the Mazda Miata. Now, we've reinvented financing with Mazda's innovative new progressive payment plan. If you qualify, Mazda's progressive payment plan will dramatically lower your payments for the first year. Mazda, re-engineering the way you buy a car. See your Mazda dealer or log on to MazdaUSA.com today for details.
If you're ready to lose weight, muscle up, and get back into shape, I've got a free video you're gonna love.
Introducing a winning fitness strategy.
You gotta eat healthy, drink plenty of water, and most importantly, strength train with Bowflex.
Strength training adds muscle. Not only does your shape look better, you actually increase your metabolism.
Hey, I'm 41, and I'm in the best shape of my life. And I can tell you, Bowflex really does work.
For a free video and brochure on the machine that can help you get into great shape at any age, call right now.
Here, LSU is one under to Loyola Marymount. take a look at the foul trouble. Tony Walker has already fouled out for Loyola Marymount. Chris Jackson for LSU.
James, I tell you, it was really, I call it a brain lock. Chris Jackson, for whatever reason, thought he had three fouls and a foul to give. I mean, I'm sure given an opportunity to take it back, he would rather be in this contest because he is a real competitor, and anybody that competes wants to be in it when it counts. It counts now.
Lowry had been 6 of 6 from the free throw line. He's missed his last two. He's 6 of 8. And Maurice Williamson moves to the point guard spot for LSU.
Well, they got to start going inside as LSU because you lose your leading scorer. The only people that have scored better other than that have been both Roberts and O'Neal. So you've got to find ways to get them the basketball.
Let's see how LSU operates without Chris Jackson there. And Roberts drops it in. A one-point LSU lead.
Well, the other thing they lose besides the scoring is some of the ball handling ability of Chris Jackson. The big fella takes it there now.
A three-point Louisiana State lead. And a steal by Vernell Singleton. Excellent defense. And a foul by Bo Kimble. Fourth personal foul on Bo Kimble.
Bo Kimble. His fourth personal foul.
Been making great plays on both ends of the court. You see Shaquille O'Neal, again, just being so active, using his overpowering strength and height just to take the ball to the basket. There was not much Hank Gathers could do but watch. You see right there, Dale Ellis been pouring on Mo Williamson. Dale Brown, let's get some defense. Now, they've done a good job defensively, and I tell you again, the guy who's really come up with the steal has been Vernell Singleton. He had both of those steals, allowing LSU the opportunity to be right here on the foul line.
This is his first trip to the free throw line. Stanley Roberts, only a 52% free throw shooter. And it's rebounded by Terrell Lowry with 1:43 remaining, a three-point deficit for the Lions. Lowry for three. Rebounded by Roberts. LSU obviously looking to protect the ball and loses it. This is where not having Chris Jackson hurts.
Exactly. That's what the full court pressure does to you. Don't have your ball handling in, not just your leading scorer, but your ball handling.
Kimble blocked by O'Neal, number 12. And Williamson is fouled. Terrell Lowry.
Protecting the middle all afternoon has been Shaquille O'Neal. This is nothing new if you've been watching this game. Protecting it again. He's been blocking shots, coming up with rebounds. He's just had a great afternoon. Now, that's not necessarily a bad foul we just saw right there. Terrell Lowry has fouled Maurice Williamson. Williamson's only a 59% foul shooter, so that's something that you may see a bit more of from Loyola.
Seven games, Williamson has shot at an 81% clip from the free throw line. And it was his two free throws that helped him to win against Mississippi in the closing seconds. AT&T Pebble Beach Golf coming next. LSU lead with 1:04 remaining. Kimble cuts it to two that quickly.
That was a raindrop.
Well, they say that's how he got his nickname, the Rainbow Jump Shot. And of course, on the playground, they just shorten it and call him Bo.
Oh my goodness, he just tore that one up.
Williamson.
Well, you see great confidence there by Mo Williamson. He's been struggling. You asked if he would take over. He's done just that, James. It's come forth right here.
This is Laura Patterson. She's saving a bundle on long-distance calls to Grandma using MCI 5 cents every day.
When Laura was born, I counted on Mom to talk me through everything.
She'd call 2-3 times a day. How do I do this? How do I do that?
Mom was always calling me.
It was like we rediscovered each other. Then we got the phone bills.
No college tuition for you.
Now we use MCI 5 cents every day. It's brand new. Calls are just 5 cents a minute every evening and 5 cents a minute all weekend long. That's half the price of AT&T for these calls.
And that's good.
And you can get daytime calls the rest of the week for just 7 cents a minute.
Now we can call each other any day of the week without worrying about the cost, whether it's just to shoot the breeze or for the really important stuff.
It's Grandma.
MCI 5 cents every day. To sign up, call 1-800-933-0518.
Say hi, Grandma.
Ask about our great international rates, too.
You're watching LSU versus Loyola Marymount from February 3rd, 1990, here on ESPN Classic.
All right, Timmy, in a ball game, indeed it is. In overtime, LSU leading by four, 145 to 141. One timeout remaining for LMU, and Maurice Williamson has really risen to the challenge.
Well, he really has, and it's got to do a great deal for the confidence of the young Tigers, because without their starter and their chief player in Chris Jackson, Williamson has stepped forth and really taken this game over.
Stanley Roberts with a big rebound of a Jeff Fryer miss. And you can see Williamson's confidence oozing. Bo Kimble fouls Vernell Singleton. Five personal fouls on Bo Kimble. So Bo Kimble will leave the game with 32 points and 11 rebounds.
You know, it never seemed as though Bo Kimble got into his scoring rhythm, yet he still ended up with 32 points, which is great for him. What we have is a little bit of a conversation as to determine whether or not there's a fifth foul on Bo Kimble, but there's no question about it.
As Chris Jackson seated on the bench with his fifth personal foul, and Chris Jackson said that indeed it was awfully good to have Maurice Williamson stepping up his game a notch the last seven games, because the team could depend on him. It'll be great basketball action coming your way tomorrow, NBA style. Utah Jazz and the Detroit Pistons, 1 o'clock Eastern time, right here on CBS. Vernell Singleton, 20 points. Is only 2 of 5 at the line, make it 3 of 6.
That's the one that he almost had to have, JB. Even though with the three foul shot, it gives the whole team confidence, because Vernell Singleton is only a 60% shooter. Now everybody else will start feeling more comfortable just trying to run off the clock should they get the ball back.
Rebound by Roberts, stolen by Lowry. LSU ball. Roberts trying to make like a guard, fouled by Tom Peabody. Producer of NCAA basketball on CBS Sports is Bob Dekus. Today's telecast has been produced by Bob Monsbach and directed by John McDonough. Halftime is produced by Steve Shear and directed by Kathy Barreto. The senior producer of CBS Sports is David Winter, and the executive producer of CBS Sports is Ted Shaker. One of two from the free throw line for Stanley Roberts. 21 points and 12 rebounds, so a big outing for Stanley. Fryer for three. And LSU wins the sprint.
I'm Ron Swoboda for the 69 Miracle Mets. And you're watching ESPN Classic.
Big fella rolling, ain't he?